Hello and welcome. My name is Nicholas, and I'm here to help you get started on understanding fractions. In this video, I will help you learn what the basics of fractions are, what they are, what they're made of, and how to show them on a number line. And hopefully, by the end of the video, you will be ready to learn more. So, let's get started. So, what is a fraction? Well, a fraction is a number that we can represent as a quotient of two other numbers. It usually, in the same way as a decimal number, represents a part of some whole. Let's take 2/3 as an example and see how we can write it. First, draw a fraction bar. After that, we need to write in the two numbers above and below that bar. This bottom number is something that we call a denominator, and it tells us how many times we have divided something. We're talking about a third, meaning that we divide one whole into three parts. The second number, the one on top, we call a numerator. As the name might suggest, the numerator represents how many parts our fraction has. In this case, we divided our whole into three parts, but are only looking for 2/3, which means we write a 2 in the numerator place. And there we have it. We can read this fraction as 2/3 or 2/3. We use fractions to represent parts of a whole. And as we did with the decimal numbers, that means that we can put this number on a number line, like so. All right, 2/3 is a number between 0 and 1, meaning that now we're going to write on the number line the numbers 0 and 1 and split them into three parts. Why three parts? Well, our denominator tells us that we are going to split this number into thirds. So we're going to put a mark here on 1/3, there on 2/3, and in the end, the final mark will go on 3/3, or as we call it, just one whole. Because if you split something into three parts and then basically join those three parts, you will get the whole yet again. As we are looking for 2/3, we're going to put a dot right here on 2/3, and we've done it. Plotting 2/3 on the number line showed us that its value is somewhere between 0 and 1. This is an example of a proper fraction. A proper fraction is a fraction that has a larger denominator value, or the bottom number, than its numerator value, or the top number. Okay, so if we have proper fractions, that also means that we have improper fractions. Simply put, they're the opposite. We have a larger numerator value than the value of the denominator that's on the bottom. Okay, let's take a look at 7/3 and see how that looks like. First, we'll bring out our number line and then extend it a bit further. Now, let's divide every distance between each whole number into thirds. We can label them accordingly, starting with 4/3, then 5/3, 6/3, 7/3, 8/3, and 9/3. And here it is. 7/3 is shown as a number between 2 and 3. If we zoom in a bit, we can see that if we add 1/3 to the number 2, we will get to the exact same place as 7/3. Let's use that knowledge to write 7/3 as 2 wholes plus 1/3, or rather 2 1/3. This form is called a mixed fraction, and every improper fraction can be written in this form. We see that if we can convert improper fractions into mixed fractions, then we can do the inverse as well. Simply multiply the denominator with the whole part and then add it to the numerator. 3 times 2 gives us 6. Adding 6 and 1 gives us 7. And there we have it. We reverted our mixed form back into the improper form. This concludes our introduction to our world of fractions, and now hopefully you have a better grasp of understanding proper and improper fractions and are ready to learn more in the future. Until the next video, like and subscribe, and have a nice day. See you.